Our next operation is subtraction of rational numbers. Now, while subtracting two rational numbers, add the additive inverse of the rational number that is being subtracted to the other rational number. So, we have to add the additive inverse of the rational number that is being subtracted to the other rational number. So, before doing the problem, so what is meant by additive inverse? So, a positive rational number is given, its additive inverse is a negative rational number. A change of sign occurs. Then, a negative rational number is given, its additive inverse is a positive rational number. Now, 3 by 4 is given, its additive inverse is negative 3 by 4. So, we can give the negative sign to the numerator, or we can put it as the common sign. Then, negative 1 by 2. So, a negative rational number is given, its additive inverse is positive, that is a 1 by 2. Negative 11 by negative 7. What is the additive inverse? Negative 11 by negative 7 can be written as 11 by 7. Make the denominator positive. You have to make the denominator positive. So, you have to multiply both numerator and denominator by negative 1. So, you will get it as 11 by 7. So, the given rational number is 11 by 7. So, its additive inverse is negative 11 by 7. 5 by negative 12. Make the denominator positive. So, all the time, no need to multiply with, no need to show the multiplication there. So, we can directly write down the answer. So, it will be equal to negative 5 by 12. So, the rational number is a negative 5 by 12. So, its additive inverse is a 5 by 12. And again, now look at that. The rational number 3 by 4. And you add the additive inverse of a 3 by 4. That is a negative 3 by 4. So, what is the sum? So, the denominators are same. Therefore, 3 plus negative 3 by 4 equal to 0 by 4. So, the answer is a 0. Now, take the second one. Negative 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. Negative 1 by 2 is the rational number. Its additive inverse is a 1 by 2. Add. Find the sum. Then, negative 1 plus 1 by 2 equal to 0 by 2. Is equal to 0. So, we can say that the sum of a rational number and its additive inverse is always 0. Sum of a rational number and its additive inverse. Sum of a rational number and its additive inverse is always 0. Now, we can consider the example. Now, first one, the denominators are same. So, how to find out the difference between these two rational numbers? Find out the difference between the numerators. That is a 5 minus 3 by 8. So, 5 minus 3 is a 2, 2 by 8. And we can reduce to the lowest form. So, we can divide both numerator and denominator by 2. So, we will get the answer as a 1 by 4. Then, the second one. Denominators are different. So, how we can find out the difference? Now, one method, we can take the LCM, then we can find out the difference between, we have to write the mass with the common denominator, and after that we can find out the difference between the numerators and we can find out the answer. And the other way of doing is, take the additive inverse of the rational number that is being subtracted. Take the additive inverse of a 3 by 8 and add with the first rational number. So, I will show you both the methods. So, which one you want, you can take it. Now, the first way, we have to find out the LCM of 7 and 8. So, what is the LCM of 7 and 8? 7 into 8 is equal to 56. Therefore, 5 by 7 minus 3 by 8 equal to 5 by 7, you have to change the denominator as 56. Therefore, you have to multiply with 8. So, 5 into 8 by 7 into 8 minus 3 by 8. Therefore, you have to multiply with 7. So, 3 by 8 into 7. And the denominator also you have to multiply with 7. Then equal to 5 into 8, 40. 40 by 56 minus 21 by 56. So here we have to do the operation as a subtraction. Therefore, denominators are same. So find out the difference between the numerators. 40 minus 21 by 56. Then equal to, what is 40 minus 21? 90. So 19 by 56. So the answer is 19 by 56. Suppose if you are doing it, the taking the additive inverse and doing the problem. 5 by 7 minus 3 by 8 equal to 5 by 7 plus, we have to add the additive inverse of 3 by 8. So 5 by 7 plus additive inverse of 3 by 8. So which is equal to 5 by 7 plus, what is the additive inverse of 3 by 8? Additive inverse of 3 by 8 is a negative 3 by 8. Then we have to produce, that means we have to proceed the same way. We have to find out the LCM. LCM is a 56. Therefore, the first one we can write 5 by 7 into 8, then plus negative 3 by 8. You have to multiply both numerator and denominator by 7, then which is equal to 40 by 56 plus negative 21 by 56. Then which is equal to 40 plus negative 21 by 56. So what is 40 plus negative 21? We go to just 19. So 19 by 56. So you can use any one of the methods, that is straight away you can do the subtraction, or the second way we have to take the additive inverse of the second rational number and add with the first one. Then 2 by 7 minus negative 5 by 6. So which is equal to 2 by 7 plus, what we can write, additive inverse of negative 5 by 6. Additive inverse of negative 5 by 6 equal to 2 by 7 plus, what is the additive inverse of negative 5 by 6? It is a 5 by 6. Then LCM of 7 and 6. What is LCM of 7 and 6? LCM of 7 and 6 equal to 7 into 6, which is equal to 42. Therefore, two by 7, you have to multiply both numerator and denominator by 6, plus 5 by 6, multiply both numerator and denominator by 7. Therefore, we will get it as 12 by 42 plus 35 by 42. 12 plus 35, what you will get? 47. 47 by 42. So the answer is a 47 by 42. So here we added the additive inverse of a negative 5 by 6. So 2 by 7 plus additive inverse of a negative 5 by 6. You can additive inverse on negative 5 by 6, no need to write down all the time. You can straight away keep that idea in your mind and you can straight away write down 2 by 7 plus 5 by 6. Now exercise 9.2, question number 2, the first one. Find 7 by 24 minus 17 by 36. So So which is equal to, we have to find out the LCM of 24 and 36. So LCM of 24 and 36. So we can start with the 2, 12, 18, then 2, 6, 9, then with the 3, 2, 3, with the 2, 1, 3, then again with the 3, 1, 1. So what is LCM? 2 into 2 into 3 into 2 into 3 equal to 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12. Then 12 into 2, 24, 24 into 3. So 72. So the LCM is 72. Therefore, 7 by 24, you have to multiply both numerator and denominator by which number? You have to get it as 72. So into 3. 24 into 3 is 72, therefore, into 3, minus 17 by 36, you have to multiply both numerator and denominator by 2, therefore equal to 7 3s are 21, 21 by 72 minus 34 by 72, then which is equal to 21 minus 34 by 72. Now how will you find out 21 minus 34? So here we can apply the additive inverse. Okay, so 21 plus negative 34 by 72. So if you did not apply the additive inverse in the first part itself, that means when we come to do the subtraction, we will automatically apply the additive inverse there. Therefore 21 plus negative 34. 34 minus 21. So negative 13 by 72. So the answer is a negative 13 by 72. Now the next one, 5 by 63 minus bracket, it is given as negative 6 by 21. So in this case we can take the additive inverse and we can add it. Otherwise sometimes we will forget to take the negative sign. So we can straight away write 5 by 63 plus additive inverse of negative 6 by 21. What is additive inverse of negative 6 by 21? 6 by 21. Additive inverse of negative 6 by 21. So equal to 5 by 63 plus 6 by 21. Now we have to take the LCM of 63 and 21. 63, 21. So we can start with the 7. So these two numbers will come in the table of a 7. So we can start with the 7. 7 9s are 63. Then 7 3s are 21. Then with the 3, 3, 1. Again with the 3, 1, 1. So what you will get? 7 3s are 21. 21 into 3, 63. So 63 is a multiple of 21. So we can straight away write down the LCM as what? 63. So LCM is a 63. Therefore, first one is a 5 by 63 itself plus 6 by 21. You have to multiply with a 3. So we'll get it as 5 by 63 plus 18 by 63. So which is equal to 5 plus 18 by 63. So the answer is 23 by 63. So the answer is 23 by 63. Now question number 5. Negative 2, 1 by 9 minus 6. So which is equal to negative of 2, 1 by 9 minus 6. Now we can convert to 2 1 by 9. 2 9s are 18. 18 plus 1, 19. So negative 19 by 9 minus 6. We can write it in the rational form as 6 by 1. We can write it as a 6 by 1. Then what is LCM of 9 and 1? 9. So 19, negative 19 by 9 is a negative 19 by 9 itself minus 6 by 1 into 9 into 9. So we'll get it as negative 19 by 9 minus 6 9s are 54. 54 by 9. Then equal to negative 19 minus 54 by 9. Denominators are same, so you have to find out the difference between the numerators. So negative 19 minus 54, which is equal to negative 19 plus negative 54 divided by 9 equal to 19 plus 54. So negative 73 by 9. So negative 19 plus negative 54 equal to negative 73 by 9. So we can write down the answer as a negative 73 by 9. So we can convert it into the mixed form also. So this one is equivalent to 73 by 9. Take the negative sign outside. Then equal to 73 by 9, 9 8s are 72. Okay, so 8 1 by 9. So we can put the minus sign outside and the answer is 8 1 by 9. Now homework, exercise 9.2, question number 2, 3rd and 4th. That's all for today's class. Thank you.